In this lecture class, we can learn about wireless LAN. So LAN means we know that is a local area network. So wireless LAN means is the medium for communication is wireless. So now we can see about the architecture of wired and wireless LAN. In a wireless LAN, we can say that the medium will be air, and the signal will be transferred or broadcast from one place to another, and which will be connected to the devices, internet device, with the help of the LAN. And host, what is meant by host here? That is, the host will be in connection with another one without a physical connection, so it can move freely, can use the services provided by the network. An isolated LAN, a wireless isolated LAN, can be called as an ad hoc network in wireless LAN technology. And the concept of the link layer switch does not exist in ad hoc wireless LAN, because here in the ad hoc network, each host or each device will be acting like a sundered unit, whereby we can able to have a communication. Now we can see about an isolated LAN and a ad hoc network. In the isolated LAN, we have a switch as the controller, and in the ad hoc network, we are not having any controller. Each host itself will be transmitting the data by having an access point. Now we can see about the characteristics of the wireless LAN. Attenuation. So loss of signal is called attenuation. The strength of the electromagnetic signal decreases rapidly because of signal degradation. Because when signal getting low range, and that is on the way of propagation. And interference, a receiver may receive signals not only from the internet sender but also from other senders. So this occurs when they were using the same kind of frequency band. Then multipath propagation, another one, radio propagation mechanism we have in wireless communication. A receiver may receive more than one signal from the same sender, because we know that the electromagnetic signals can get reflected or diffracted or scattered on the way to the receiver. And because of these all, we can say that the receiver will be getting different signals, time dispersed signals arriving from the sender. So when considering these all the characteristics of the wireless network, we can expect errors. Also we can able to detect errors. So errors and error detection are more important in wireless network than in wired network. And because of this reason, we need to consider a lot here with these terms and parameters when it comes to the wireless network. And IEEE has defined the wireless LAN as IEEE 802.11. Here it is having two architecture, one is BSS, basic service set, and one is called extended service set. The basic service set is the building block for the wireless LAN, and here it is having the access point, that is every base station will be provided with the access point. So here you can see about the basic service set approach, where every network will be provided with the access point. And another thing is extended service set. An extended service set is made up of actually two or more basic service set with access point. So one thing we need to understand is every network where it will be having an access point. And through the access point only, each host can able to connect to other node or another host in the network. And IEEE 802.11 does not restrict the distributed system. It can be any IEEE LAN, such as an Ethernet. The extended service set uses two types of stations. One is mobile and one is stationary. The mobile stations are normal stations inside a basic service set. The stationary stations are access point stations, which were part of the wired LAN. So here we can able to see the extended service set. That is the architecture of the extended service set. And the simple way to understand the extended service set is when we can able to connect one or more basic service set, we can able to form an extended service set. The only thing is we need to make sure that everywhere we have access points inside the basic service set. And overall it comes under a distributed system. And the three stations, so one is no transition, one is basic service set, one is extended service set. So these were the contents we have in this IEEE 802.11. Also IEEE 802.11 will be having two sub layers for the MAC, and its functions are distributed coordination function and point coordination function. So now in this figure we can able to see that logical link control and media access control, these two are the sub layers belong to the data link layer. So one is the logic link layer, logical link control for the IEEE 802.11, and this media access control having two sections. One is called point coordination function and distributed coordination function. The distributed coordination function, it normally uses a CSMA ZA method as the access. So before sending a frame, the source station will sense the medium, it checks for the energy level, and channel uses a persistent strategy with back off until the channel is idle. And once it found that the channel is idle, the station waits for a period of time called a distributed interframe space, then sends a control frame called a request to send. And once the receiver is free, it will, after receiving the request to send from the sender, it will forward a clear to send to the sender. On receiving the clear to send message from the receiver, now the station can able to send the data frame to that receiver. And this waiting time for this is called short interframe space. So this kind of control frames are very important in this kind of stations, whereby we can able to overall have a good kind of communication. So when a station sends an RTS frame, it includes the duration of the time that it needs to occupy the channel. The stations that are affected by this transmission will be creating a timer, and any station willing to transmit during this time, they will be in a waiting section, and which will be called by the name network allocation vector. That shows how much time must pass before these stations allowed to check the channel. So the time taken for these extra stations to wait and to get the channel, and that is comes under the term network allocation vector. So this is a simple format of wireless LAN with this architecture. That's all in the class today.